Chapter 1. What is statistics?
Statistics is science of dealing with data collection. كيف تجمع بياناتك؟ How to manipulate it. كيف ترتبها؟ Organize it. كيف تنظمها؟ How to present your data. كيف تعمل presentation of your data لبياناتك؟ كيف تنظمها؟ What's and then you last finally you draw conclusions about your data. تأخذ توصيات وتكتب نتائج عن التقييم جمعته. This very simple definition of statistics. I have two types of statistics. Statistics could be descriptive or inferential. وصفي أو استقرائي. Descriptive is dealing with data collection, manipulation, and presentation. Inferential, الاستقرائي inferential is dealing with how to draw conclusions. كيف تفسر بياناتك عشان تأخذ منها نتائج. Draw conclusions. This is what we call inferential statistics. Okay, descriptive statistics can be used to organize data into meaningful form. How to organize your data. هذه تقريبا we'll cover in chapter 2 and 3. We'll cover this part. How to organize your data, summarize it, and present data in an informative way. Inferential statistics can be used to estimate properties of a population based on a sample taken from the population. استقرائي, this very elementary definition, just to know what's the feeling of inferential statistics, what is descriptive statistics. You need to know what is population, مجتمع, population, entire set of individuals of objects of interest or measurements obtained from individuals, object or objects of interest. Like we said, population of Arab Open University students is a population. Population of Saudi Arabia. Everyone living in Saudi Arabia is covered in this population. Population of animals in deserts. In a specific definition, this can be called population. To study population, it's sometimes impossible to study population. Or it's very expensive to study population. So we take a sample from this population, which is a portion or part of the population of interest. All studies depending on sample. Results of sample with some conditions can be expanded to population. انت تدرس عينة مثلا عندك دراسة تسويقية marketing عن شراء الناس عاداتهم في التسوق. And you can take a sample from stores. Take a sample with the specific size. You study this sample, find its properties, find the mean value and or standard deviation of this. Or you can draw your conclusions on sample and then you can generalize it to population. تسوي دراستك على عينة وتعمم النتيجة على المجتمع. تأخذ عينة من السكان في مكان ما وتعمم النتيجة على المجتمع كله. This population sample. لما عمم النتيجة وgeneralize this conclusion, I'll go to inferential statistics. استخدم techniques of inferential statistics. Variables, متغيرات, my variables. There are two types of variables. Could be qualitative or quantitative. متغيرات وصفية أو متغيرات رقمية. Qualitative variable. An object or individual is observed and recorded as a non-numeric characteristic. زيش مثلا, for example, gender. I said is male, female. This is variable. متغير جنس variable. ذكر أنثى. Gender. This is qualitative variable. We call it. Birth. A color. لون العيون. لون الشعر. Marital status. الحالة الاجتماعية. Single. Married. Divorced. All these are qualitative variables. If I want to do descriptive statistics for a qualitative variable, it should be different than a quantitative variable. Quantitative is numerical variable, which is numerical value like age, weight, وزن, pressure, قياس الضغط. All these are numerical variables. If it's a numerical variable, we call it quantitative. Of course, when dealing with descriptive, it's different than we're dealing with qualitative or quantitative. This is a qualitative. Quantitative variables could be discrete or continuous. Discrete, you can count it. Discrete variable, you can count it like يعني there is a gaps between the values. Number of bedrooms in a house, 2, 3, it's counted. Number of students in class, and عندنا في الفصل مثلا in class, there are 75 students, it's counted. Is this great? Continuous variable, result of measuring something. It can't be counted. When I said, what is your weight? كم وزنك? هتقول لي والله is 90 kilograms. No, it's 90. Maybe it's 90.537. It's not counted. Not fixed number. Any measurable variable, أي رقم تأخذه من قياس سواء بالوزن or pressure or any device or parameter or any device or temperature device, it's a continuous variable. أن رقم أقرأه من جهاز this is what we call continuous variable. This simple definition. Okay, the air pressure in a tire, time also is a continuous variable. Okay, عندي discrete variable متغير متقطع أو متغير متصل continuous variable. Discrete variable which is counted. أقدر أعد أحسبهم 1, 2, 3 أعدهم بدون أي اختلاف ما يختلف عليها 2 هاي discrete variable. Continuous variable variable المتغير المتصل. This is can be يعني ناخذه اللي ناخذه من قياس باختصار من جهاز يقيس لي اياه جهاز زي الساعة التايم الزمن الوقت اقيسه بالساعة اشوف الساعة كم هذا عرفت الوقت درجة الحرارة في الغرفة اشوف الجهاز درجة الحرارة واخذ الرقم هذه these numbers هذه ارقام it's called discontinuous variable simply الفرق بين discrete والcontinuous either qualitative or quantitative. Qualitative الوصفية اللي هي قلنا which is like marital status, hair color, gender هاي متغيرات qualitative نوعية أو وصفية qualitative. Quantitative اللي هي الرقمية اللي قلنا قبل شوية quantitative قلنا either discrete or continuous. This quantitative either discrete or أنواع المتغيرات نوعين qualitative or quantitative. Qualitative النوعية اللي هي بالأمثلة ما فيها تفصيل الكوانتيتيف الرقمية لا قد تكون منفصلة ديسكريت أو كونتينيوس أو كونتينيوس. I need to know levels of measurement. القياس المقاييس لها مستويات. There are four levels of measurements. And they have this nominal, ordinal, interval and ratio. I need to know this because sometimes in analysis when I use a software to analyze my data, computer asks me what is your data? Is it nominal or ordinal or interval or ratio? I need to distinguish between these four types. Nominal and ordinal should be, this is descriptive. Nominal ordinal جاية في qualitative variable. This first two, nominal and ordinal. Nominal, نأخذ النومينال اللي هو بالعربي يسموه الاسمي nominal variable. Nominal level of measurement. Like what's your gender, male, female, it's nominal. What is your hair color, brown, black, gray, whatever. Where do you live, north, south? This is descriptive. This we call nominal variable. But they have no order. الترتيب غير مهم. يعني أقول okay, أقول male, female, or female, male. Order is not important. Or what is your hair color, brown, black, or said black, brown. Doesn't make difference. وين ديفرنس متى يكون الفرق له أهمية الترتيب له أهمية بتكلم على الجريدز والله درجتي ألف excellent or very good B or C or D or E هنا الجريدز درجات تقدير الدرجات هنا الترتيب arrangement is important ordering is important this what we call اللي هو second type of measurement اللي هو الordinal هنشوف الآن الordinal level of ordinal اللي هي المقاييس measurements evaluation التقييم انت مثلا راضي جدا غير راضي راضي somehow اللي هو evaluation في questionnaire في الاستبيانات هذه this is ordinal مهم تعرف تميز بين النوعين من البيانات هذه ordinal level كلها ارقام كلها متغيرات وصفيه but ordinal arrangement الترتيب order is very important حتى لو كانت احيانا ارقام should be it's known as numbers. How do you feel today? Very happy. Happy, okay. Unhappy, very unhappy. في السيستم اكتب 5, 5, 4, or 1 or 2. But 5, I know 5 it is very happy. 4 it is happy, and so on. This is what we call ordinal variable. Third level, interval level of measurement. For that, I recorded at the interval level measurement, the interval of the distance between values is meaningful. A scale with a known unit of measurement, like Fahrenheit or Celsius temperature scales, مقياس درجات الحرارة, and dress size, مقاسات الملابس, small, medium, large, extra. There is a gap, الترتيب هنا الانترفال ديستانس في مسافة, في قياس فرق يعني بين small والmedium, بين medium واللarge, is a distance, is a meaningful distance between this interval. الratio, if zero is the same, ratio is the same as interval, but the zero point, لما يكون في قيمة صفر معناته غياب قيمة, ما في قيمة. لكن الويج, like example, الأجور, wages or change in stock price, التغير في الأسعار البورصة, stock prices, أسعار الأسهم. لما يكون zero, أنت ما تغير. يعني zero point هنا معناته ما في تغيير. No change, zero. This is what we call ratio level. What is ordinal? What is nominal? Then ratio and interval. This could be this simple name, this nominal. Ordinal is nominal and ordered variable, named and ordered variable. Interval named plus ordinal plus proportional interval in a zero absent of relation. This summary of measurements. ملخص للقياسات, this nominal, ordinal, interval, ratio. Consider the graph of the orders done by customers in an Italian restaurant over a given week. أعطاني, give me this chart, أعطاني الرسمة هذه. هنأخذ الشارت هذه إن شاء الله next chapter. What is the type of variable under study? إيش نوع المتغير اللي عندي؟ أنا عندي متغير, what's my variable here? أنواع البيتزا, production of this restaurant, which is the selling pasta, pizza, هذه ريزيتو, كالزوني. هذا نوع الفاريبل. ايش نوع الفاريبل؟ هذا رقمي, هذا وصف, هذا this is called equality, qualitative. This اختار انه this variable is qualitative, وصف, وليس quantity. Quantitative numbers, ارقام. Qualitative, no, which is descriptive. طيب B, according to customer, what's the most favorite order, ايش اعلى طلب هنا, most favorite order. هلاقي this one 16, أكثر طلب عندي 16, which is calzone, and you تكتب calzone, or select, you can write or select. How many orders were done during the week? كم order باعوا في الأسبوع? How many orders? You can add this معهم 11 plus 15 plus 8 plus 16 to become 50 orders. What's the percentage of pizza orders? Pizza orders. شوف كم النسبة المئوية للمبيعات البيتزا. كم بيتزا, كم باع البيتزا, كم باعوا البيتزا؟ 50 اقسمها على كم؟ على المجموع اللي هو الخمسين 50 ونضرب في 100 يعطيني البرسنتج. A sample of 500 customers were asked, how did you know about our product? في عندي 5 options, اما billboards or radio and TV or social media or friends and neighborhoods. What's the type of the variable under study? ايش نوع المتغير هذا؟ Again, نفسه, it's a qualitative variable. Suggest another graph that can be used to represent the data. هناخذها ايش انواع الرسوم. هذا الرسوم, this chart, ايش نسميه, what we call this chart, this we call it pie chart. هذا الرسمه pie chart, قطاع دائري. I can represent my data in bar charts, في شكل اعمده بيانيه. Listen, you can see that I can use bar chart instead of pie chart. How many customers know about the product from billboards? Billboards is 20%. كم شخص ال 20%؟ How many persons? My sample is 500, is given in the question. العينة عندي 500. طب ال 20% منهم كم؟ نقول 500 times 0.2 equal 100 customers.